Okay, hey people, how are you? So is T-28 OP tank in tier 4? Well, World Tanks announced that they will, you know, nerf this tank because it is. So let's see. But before we see that, I need to announce one thing, one bad thing. You know, I said I don't have, you know, free space on disk to download some of old clients to show some of your replays that you sent me while I was in school. Well, I didn't save previous patch, just changed a few days ago. So some of you sent very good replays, including a very, very great battle by Washer in SU-100. And that was shot from KV-222 HE round. And unfortunately, I didn't save that client also. And just one day of, you know, pause, and now we cannot use that replay because client changed. So here I can go back to AP runs, which I doing a little bit slower, but I just wanted to save that Excelsior, you know. Look at that, even shooting in green, you know, we are just rarely penetrating. So as soon as we switch to AP here around, we are penetrating. Isn't that lovely? So a little bit of APCR, you know. Back to AP. Well, I was going for the truck, I don't know why I did that. Oh, I know why I did that, he was running away. And now frontally I have no chance to pen him. He stand around. So I switch to APCR. And do you know, just few people know that toughest armor on Excelsior is frontally. On Churchill too. So you will see them often driving sideways. That is like only group of people that driving their heavy tanks sideways, and they have worst armor sideways, you know. So you saw one round even from AP went there. So now I'm thinking, okay, let's go in base, but they are still strong in middle, you know. So I just auto-locked that Stug, you know, it is Stug 3B, so it should be going in. No shots on Mate A1. And I decided, okay, let's help a little bit in middle, and then enemy looks, you know, he, you know, become mad because his team didn't do anything. So he went there, he killed T-34, and he wants to kill them all, you know. But we have their M10RBFM radio, you know. So he is running away, loading or something. Okay, we detract him. And yeah, that I shouldn't shoot in that pillar because it stopped my round. But I was somehow expecting that it will go through it and into that thing. So now you know that doesn't happen, you know. So I'm trying to avoid artillery now, you know. I went down there, and those two, are they bots, you know? Are they bots? Or they love to watch each other? So now I know what is wrong with my games, you know? Wargaming will populate heavy tanks with bots, you know, and with Excelsior, so it is commercial also, and nobody will even notice that they are bots, because, you know, heavy tank drivers usually, you know, acting like bots anyway. So like you saw, I was very careful to shoot only when he is behind the tree. But when I ran out of tree, I shot him one more time, you know, to try to kill it or stop it. And there you go, Mate A1, one of previously spotted. Ooh, he catch me this time with his HE round, but not good enough. And he's struggling for gun elevation, I'm struggling for gun depression, and he is down. And now just three artillery left. One of them managed to damage me. Shooting in, luckily that was side cut, you know, on tracks, so it stopped a little bit of that penetration. Ooh, that was very close, and there you go, bots now going in. Now it is safe, just artillery left. So actually Washer took that shot, you know, and one of bots took that one. And I don't know how we missed that so close, and that is the end of this artillery. So, brightest thing about this replay is actually this camo, you know. Just look at it. It is crazy. It is not camo, you know. It is paint job, you know. Well, it would be camo in some autumn, you know, wood in Pripyat or Chernobyl. So yeah, this tank is not OP, but it is very damn good if you using this tank carefully. It has speed, you know, and it has fast firing gun, and many, you know, new people would think, oh, well, I have speed, that means I can go there and go fast, blazing with my gun, you know, and I will kill them all. Well, actually, you have speed just to go fast from point A to point B, you know, and that doesn't necessarily mean, wait for it, to go in enemy base in start of the match. So you just find a good position, you do initial damage, and then you can go hunting with this tank. And even then it can be nasty, you know, if that even tier 4 artillery shot me anywhere on really open armor, this is spaced armor on tracks, then it would be nasty, you know. So that's it. Let's see postgame data and who did what. Okay, so this is my second M badge in new patch last night in T28. I lost a lot of credits, you know. Would we win without it? Probably, you know. Maybe, but you know, I just don't have nerves to bounce there all the time, you know, so 78 shots fired, that is a lot, and 58 on target, that is okay, you know, accuracy. 11 tanks damage and we killed 4. 7 minutes and 20 seconds of playing. Set on experience. 1114 stats of experience. 4 kills and 2746 HP of damage. So their best player in experience is actually that KV-222. Wow. So mostly he was just spotting. So what about their looks? Is this looks? No, this is not looks. Oh, this is looks. So why that looks didn't do? Well, he was spotting, you know, but yeah, 4 enemy tanks spotted, but no damage, you know. About that, you know. When you're spotting, there is no point to spot people that your team cannot shoot. So there is that map Sand River, and there is that map Prohorovka, you know. So they will go on those dunes in the middle, you know, and spot in Sand River people that are going on dunes too or on those hills. And nobody can shoot them there, you know. So what is the point? You don't shoot in them, you going up, being spotted, then they shooting at you. Second map, so you should go either alone, I mean, either all the way to the hills, so you can shoot at them and spot them. Or you should go left in that channel dunes, you know, not in a river, but on left, you know. And then there is that other map, Prohorovka, you know. And then they spotting there. Of course, when there is artillery or more artillery, there is, you know, point in doing that. But passive spotting on one of flanks, it is what you know, need. Then they will shoot at you and eventually you will die and your team will lose scout and they will, you know, left without spotted flanks. And then there is that map Fisherman's Bay, you know. So people will go in the middle. Well, why you would go in middle there? From middle they can just, you know, go in middle, in center, and then they will die there, you know, if they try. So they can spot something from there, but if they spot something from there and they hurt it, well, it is their fault because they allow that, you know. So securing flanks, you know, don't go in middle, secure flanks. So when you secure flanks or at least one flank, then there is good chance that the middle will fall on its own. At least that is my vision. And now enough of BS, let's say what we need to say. That is goodbye, people. Goodbye. Well, to those at least who watching this, few of those who watching these videos, because this is probably my last video. I'm going back to college, and that is that. Maybe we will see each other on summer. So thank you for watching, thank you for being with me, thank you for sending your replays and comments and likes and support. That is just awesome. And those who stayed with me like I am, you know, hard and nasty, well, thank you even more. So God bless you and see ya.